This isn't the Bureau's first time in Bright Falls. 1970s, 6, 8. Last one was in 2010. It's not exactly clockwork, but this town sees way more altered world events than most. We knew it was just a matter of time before the lake acted up again. After the AWE in 2010, the FBC's research department set up a facility, the Lake House, to study the threshold in Cauldron Lake, find better ways to contain the entity inside. Your tax dollars at work. When we detected a spike in paranatural activity at Cauldron Lake, before I even knew you were on this case, Saga, the Lake House was my first thought. I was shorthanded, hoped they could spare some help, maybe give us some intel on the situation. If I had any clue what was waiting for us in there, Saga, I'd have just kept on driving. This is Agent Kieran Estevez responding to an AWE alert in the vicinity. I need to speak with the Marmons. So much for the welcome wagon. You all set up the perimeter. We're on the threshold's doorstep, so keep your eyes peeled.
Yes, ma'am.
This shouldn't take long, okay? You see anything, radio me.
Roger that.
The Lake House was run by the research department. Research and investigations don't really see eye to eye. What they call science, I call a violation of Bureau protocol and human decency. Classic interdepartmental drama. Your FBI saga, you know how it goes. In retrospect, my low opinion of the research department may have clouded my judgment. Agent Kieran Estevez, Investigations Department. No one wants to check the individual carrying a firearm into a restricted government facility?
Hello.
No?
And welcome to another exciting day here at the Lake House. As I'm sure you know, I am Dr. Jules Marmont, and this is my wife,
Dr. Diana Marmont.
And together we are the heads of research at this facility. We want to thank you all for helping us break new ground in our study of Cauldron Lake.
That's right.
Dr. Marmont's not here. Nobody is? I'll have to check downstairs.
Wonderful joke, Jules. We'll see you down there.
They must all be working on the lower levels. We'll need to head down. This should come in handy. soon as I got in that elevator, my bad news detector started going nuts.
Estevesta team, something's going on in the lake house. I want all nearby agents to...
Oh, shit!
Converge on the facility now. Belay that order. Shit.
A threshold event had hit the lake house. Now, it was the Marmont's problem. Our mission was outside. To get back to the elevator. Dr. Darling? That is not a regulation FBC weapon. Can't open it from the side. Okay, okay. Priority one, get the lights on. Standing around in the dark near Cauldron Lake is not smart. The way I saw it, there was only one way out. Identify the source of the event and contain or eliminate it. Now, good news, I just had to keep going down. Bad news, the elevator liked to disappear. The elevator's back.
were those things?
You never really get used to the shit you see in this job, but you can learn techniques to adjust, to function. Take 6 deep breaths, then get to work. Find the source, collapse the threshold. What kind of entity are you?
Murder and victim. The
you can speak. That means you probably imprinted on a person or retained some of your former self's information. Previously human, maybe? Okay, I can work with that. I just had an unpleasant encounter with some other painted individuals. Any relation?
A thousand paintings used, crude.
What does that mean?
Paint no brush, a self-portrait!
Okay, hey, calm down!
Filing his eyes and hands and bones.
News? That thing is really pissed off. Good news. It didn't try to kill me. Okay, baby steps.
Angry living paintings are not typically on the Cauldron Lake bingo card. Something different was happening at the lake house, and I couldn't let it escape. Bright Falls didn't need this particular cherry on its already shitty sundae.
Thank you. crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in, but the water could not flow. It became trapped, stagnant, went bad. The truth was controlled here. The art was not art, just content for the experiment. There was a crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in.
Please don't let this be what I think it is.
As you know by now, typewriters and Cauldron Lake do not mix. And a room full of them all clacking away. 100% bad news. Say no to extra firepower. Back where I started. Spatial recurrence. Usually observes the law of three.
This contrived overlap bound it on itself. Compressing, compounding, reflecting and refracting. An urban legend and a murder in constant imbalance. Cause and effect hopelessly tangled. Arranged wrong, the dream logic.
Shadows here. I think we've done. Loop 3 should be the last one.
Alan Wake's writing is being studied here. Do you know anything about him?
Names don't matter. A thousand more to come.
They say clear communication is the key to any relationship. You and I have some work to do there. What happened to you? Did the people here do this to you?
Mormons!
You said Marmonts before. Do they do this? Where are they now?
Misery! Hate.
Tell me where they are! Fixated on the Marmonts. What did they do?
Threshold is the connection between a foreign reality and our own. Now, they all have their own rules, strange as they are. But the further down I went, the more chaotic this one got. Clearly, this was the Cauldron Lake threshold, but something was wrong. Well, more wrong than usual.
Sublevel 2.
Level-wise lockdown in effect. Please remain calm. Level-wise lockdown in effect. Please remain calm.
Access card. Sorry, but I need this. There.
Lockdown lifted. You are now safe.
Thank you. My team was on sublevel one. I knew they were in danger. The Marmonts turned innocent people into tools using the FBC's authority. They thought they were untouchable out here, hidden away in the woods. No. Actions have consequences. And I'm the consequences.
Sublevel one.
Bastard.
Jules Marmont killed my team. He was taken by the Shadow. I'm sorry. I should get that gun while I'm up here.
Not very scientific. I mean, that Shadow
comes to my lab and treats me like some kind of assistant. A putain d'assistant, moi. I run the lake house. This is my facility. Mine. You cannot just walk in here for 1 week, make some speeches, and then fly back to New York. Parce que crétin, prétentieux. The jackass thinks he's a fucking rock star!
works on these bastards. Had changed Jules Marmont into a hostile, paranatural entity. That made everything simpler. No arrest, no paperwork. I could put him down like the monster he was. We're holding a painter here. Rudolph Lane. Does that ring a bell?
The shape of a man!
I think you are, or were, Rudolph Lane.
Himself! A self-portrait! Make them see!
Look, I might be able to help you. But I need information, cooperation.
No plus! Just insane!
Rudolph Lane was dying. Both murderer and victim. Red hues ran down his hands. Was it scarlet? Cadmium. Too vivid to be maroon. Names don't matter, he decided. Color was pure. Inspiring. For the first time in years, he wanted to paint. A self-portrait. To say goodbye. No. To make them remember. To make them see what they did. He slapped his hands against the wall to steady himself. He began from there. No brush, just himself. The strokes were crude, violent. The pain, misery, and hate he'd endured there. The fire in his eyes and hands and bones all spread into the shape of a man. It was quick, natural, like a heart attack. He slumped down to the floor, smiling at the anger he left smeared across the wall.
Elevator would stop moving. Ooh, nice office.
swallow all my pride. And just like that, just like that.
Rich, Jules. Oh, and he's reportedly misplaced the manuscript pages I need for my work. Suddenly, the exact pages that I need to reference have just vanished. He is actively impeding critical bureau research. I mean, if he can do that, then what is stopping me from going down to that lab? And I don't know, just inverting the amplifiers or misaligning the receivers or both? It's the same thing in principle. He booked the lab. Some big experiment tomorrow.
Had opened the door into Cauldron Lake's threshold. It was forced. It was unstable. Shutting the experiment down was the only option.
fractures.
Agent Estevez stood in the forest just outside of Wright Falls. She watched her team detain Alan Wake and Ilmo Koskinen, stuffing them into black SUVs. She realized this was the moment Wake had been writing in the vision she had seen. The story was coming true. She pushed the thought out of her head. It had been a good tip, a way to find Wake. Nothing more.
Alan Wake!
After the threshold event collapsed, I was back at Cauldron Lake. But for a moment, I was somewhere else. I saw Alan Wake there. He was writing about me finding him in Bright Falls, in the woods. It was a good tip. I called the surviving members of my team, and I told them to meet me there. You know, these cases, they never get less ambiguous. Or easier. This one, this was tough. Because protocol says entities like the Taken are monsters, threats. But the Marmonts were monsters way before the Shadow got to them. So at the end of the day, what's the difference?